Saratoga, Texas lies on the edge of 300,000 acres of alligator and snake-infested wilderness. This imposing swath of land is known to locals as the Big Thicket. Once the sacred lands of the native Atakapa people, Europeans arrive in the 1850s and look to make their fortune plundering the area's valuable resources of lumber and oil, encroaching on an uncharted territory that some say was never meant to be disturbed. In 1902, the Santa Fe Railroad raises hundreds of acres to carve tracks from Saratoga to the remote supply outpost of Bragg. Under the command of ruthless production bosses, construction of the railroad is deadly business. While the working conditions are inhumane, eventually the rail line is finished. For decades, business is booming, but maintaining the tracks through the swamp costs countless lives. Eventually, there's a bust. When the boom dies down in the 1930s and the oil wells run dry, the rail line is pulled up and the town is abandoned, leaving nothing behind except for this dirt road and the shallow graves of the dead workers who suffered and died here. It's around this time that people start reporting ghostly lights that manifest in strange ways. Some witnesses describe bizarre floating orbs that move with an eerie intelligence. Some reportedly have the power to disable electronics, even automobiles. And while it may sound outlandish, in some cases, the lights appear to take on the shape of a headless figure carrying a lantern. Just recently, the number of sightings has exploded, and local residents are terrified. No one, including local law enforcement, can explain the glimmering phantoms of the Big Thicket, and no one has for 100 years.
Hey, Ben, how are you?
Hi.
Hey there.
Ben is the deputy editor of Skeptical Inquirer. He spent his entire career debunking alleged paranormal phenomena caught on tape. And he's all too familiar with these anomalous lights.
Okay, all right, let me pull it up.
And now he's scrutinizing the FLIR footage from our first night on the ghost road.
Wow, that was weird. Then you've got that sort of streaking something.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's it.
I'm curious, so
in the FLIR footage, we see it coming from the bottom of the screen going up.
But after that, did it like zoom into the sky? Or what happened after?
It kind of went up over the top of the canopy and then back towards the swamp.
Was it glowing?
It was. A really bright, small light in the shape of a circle.
It's not crystal clear what that is.
Something is there. And I don't know that I can fully explain it.
Still a mystery.
Still a mystery.
So the FLIR hit remains inconclusive. But what about the bright light that Evan caught on his camera? If Ben Radford, a black belt among skeptics, doesn't have a rational explanation, well, I think I'm about to catch a mean case of the I told you so's.
Do you mind taking a look at the second video?
Absolutely. Okay, I'm watching it here. That's definitely a light. I mean, that's not an optical illusion. That is
a legitimate light, whatever the hell it is.
So straight down the ghost road happens to be a highway
that veers up and then goes off to the west. And so I think what you're seeing might be car light, like a headlight or something. In most of the cases that people describe, it's a single light,
usually white or red in some cases, that appears for a while and then vanishes.
It looks to me like a car light.
To me, it doesn't look like two separate headlights, because to me, it looked like one singular light.
Yeah, well,
you're talking about a stretch of road that's, I think, 6 or 8 miles or something. And so from that distance, you're not necessarily going to be able to distinguish two separate high beams or even low beams.
They're going to appear in one single light. Yeah.
If these are car headlights.
Interesting.
Right. Ben's hypothesis is interesting, but I'm not fully convinced. After all, how can two headlights at road level appear to be a light in the sky? So tonight, we're heading back to the spot where our cameraman Evan filmed the light to pressure test Ben's theory.
All right, this is where we were the other night.
Okay.
So I think this is the perfect spot.
Evan's camera was pointed south down the ghost road when he filmed the mysterious light. At that southern tip, the road merges with Highway 787. The question is, could the lights be the result of a car traveling north on this highway as it passes the ghost road and bears to the left? It's time to find out.
What I want you to do is take the Jeep, go to the end of the road, take the highway up a little bit, and then radio me when you're coming. I'll have this camera pointed that way, I'll have the team's cameras pointed that way, and when you drive past the road entrance, maybe we'll see the same thing, and that could explain some of the Saratoga lights.
Down to the end of the road, take a left, spin it around, 3, 2, 1, I'm on my way. All right.
Since the ghost road is so straight, we should see her headlights at a great distance, but will they look normal or like something otherworldly?
Jess, we're ready for you.
Okay. Driving toward you.
Copy. Okay, time to see if we can finally unmask the Saratoga lights.
Ghost road should be straight ahead now.
All right, we got one light. We got a light.
That's crazy.
Passing the ghost road in 3, 2.
Come on, come on.
And 1. I am passing the ghost road and staying on the highway.
Ooh, there it goes. There it goes.
It matches exactly, and it looks really strange. Like, it looks like a ghost light.
This confirms that many ghost light sightings can be attributed to headlights in the distance. But even I'll admit, we're far from explaining everything.
Jess, we got it, we got it.
No kidding, all right. Okay, headed back.
Hey, hold on, my camera's getting
Wait, what?
Phil, do you see that?
Right above the trees.
My God!
Wait, you just saw a light. I'm not seeing anything. Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Hey, Phil, we just lost one of the cameras.
What? Are you kidding me?
Phil.
Hold up, hold up. Camera out.
Hurry up, come over.
All right, I'm coming your way. What just happened? Was it in front of you?
It's so dark. I would say it was right at the cusp of the tree line, and then it just floated a little bit up and then over the canopy.
Frogs over here are going nuts.
Everything's going nuts.
Animals often send out alerts when threatened. The question is, what made everything in the swamp go crazy, and what made our camera shut down?
One of the cameras went down right when you called me on walkie.
Are you serious? That's insane.
Maybe it's coincidence, maybe it's not, I don't know.
People report that the ghost lights have rendered electronics and even automobiles completely useless. We may have demonstrated that some of the lights could be cars in the distance, but whatever I just saw overhead was definitely something else.
Checking for any eyeshine right now.
See anything?
Nothing. So you saw light float into the sky.
Mm-hmm.
Now these frogs are going crazy out here.
Mm-hmm. That's really strange.
Do you really think you saw something weird tonight?
I really do think that I saw the Saratoga lights.
Well, I think I saw what people claim to be the Saratoga lights, and I got it on tape. And it was you driving by earlier, making that flash and disappearing.
Why don't we just stay out here? You've got the camera. Let's collect more evidence, and maybe we'll be able to catch on camera what I caught with my own eyes.
Okay.
We continue our search on the ghost road into early morning, hoping the light that Jess saw makes another appearance.
Nothing.
Yeah.
But no luck. The only light we'll be seeing is the sun when it breaks over the horizon. Doing all we can, we get in our car and say goodbye to the ghost road.
I feel like we definitely proved that there is such a thing as Saratoga lights. We saw them.
I'm pretty excited that we've been able to debunk at least part of this story. That really intense glow that we caught down the road, now we know exactly why that happened.